CYC is a free channel that presents the Word of God for everyone. Your support will help us to continue the mission. Visit our website, cycnow.com. Even a dollar will make a difference.
For Christ or to evangelize the good news of the gospel, there are several ways. You can actually evangelize by the word. You can evangelize by the example, by the work. You can evangelize by prayer. You can evangelize by serving others. You can evangelize through our fellowship with one another. And the last form of evangelism is suffering and accepting death for Christ. That's martyrdom. And martyr means actually a witness. Even in Arabic, معناها شهيد, يعني بيشهد لربنا. So these are different forms of evangelism. I can witness either through the word, either through the work, or through the prayer, or through serving others, or through our fellowship with one another, or through accepting suffering for Christ. I like to speak today about the first type of evangelism, which is by the word. By the word. The word, of course, it is the word of God to speak to others about God. And to speak to others about God, you should actually have good understanding of the scripture, because that is the message that you will deliver to others. But also, you should also have good understanding about the recipient, people who are receiving the message. Because to talk to an atheist is different from talking to a Muslim, different from talking to a Buddhist, etc. So, in order actually to evangelize by word, you need to study the scripture and to understand it and to live it. And also you need to understand the culture of the recipient, his perception, his understanding, his belief system, in order to address these points. And this was clear in the ministry of St. Paul. St. Paul, he preached the Jews and also he preached the Gentiles. And how he addressed the Jews was totally different than how he addressed the Gentiles. In addressing the Jews, he used several references from the Old Testament. But with the Gentiles, like in Athens, in Areopagus, he did not use any verse from the Old Testament, because they don't believe in the Old Testament. But he used actually their literature, their poems, the logic, the reason, in order to preach to them the word of salvation. And many times when we preach, we give a sermon. And there are different types of sermons in evangelism. And when I say in evangelism, actually each sermon should be evangelistic sermon. Each sermon should actually have a witness, a message about Christ to move the hearts of the people. And there are actually four types of sermons. And it's important to understand these four types of sermons. Why? Because most of us, when we preach or teach in Sunday school or give sermons, maybe we are inclined to only one type because we enjoy this type. But actually, if we understand the four types of sermons, then when we preach, actually we need to combine the four types, or maybe alternate between four types in different sermons. But if you use only one style, it will be repetitive, and you will not reach every listener. The first type of sermons, I will call it the apologetic sermons. Apologetic sermons. So these are the sermons we preach in order to prepare the ground for the gospel. These sermons address some of the common objections to Christianity. These sermons address attacks against Christianity. These sermons actually try to prove the truth and relevance of Christianity, and to demonstrate that the message of the gospel is the absolutely true message. For example, the lectures that we heard so far in this conference, I can call them apologetic sermons. For example, if I'm preaching about the resurrection of Christ, if my sermon focused on the proofs of resurrection, then this is apologetic sermon. If I'm speaking about the evidence for creation versus evolution, this is apologetic sermon. If I'm speaking that Christianity is the only way to eternal life and the only way to God, that's also apologetic sermon. If I preach about salvation and what's required in order to be saved, that's also apologetic sermon. Most of the comparative theology are apologetic sermons when I compare between Orthodoxy, Protestantism, Catholicism, Jehovah's Witness, Seventh-day Adventist, Mormon. All these are defending the truth. So these sermons are aiming toward either conversion, like helping people to join the true church, or aiming toward establishing people in their faith, to confirm them in their faith. These sermons are clearing away any confusion or any doubt from the mind of the people in order to have true and sound understanding of the gospel. These sermons deal with issues that will open the pathway for Christ and His grace. Because when I have understanding correct understanding of the Bible, then my heart actually will be open and ready to accept the grace of God and the Lord Jesus Christ himself. So these sermons are very, very essential, except in our time where there are many attacks and many confusion, and people actually are confused because there are 10,000s of interpretations for the scripture, thousands of denominations, and all of them claim they are the truth. Many, many religions, and many people actually who are trying to either reconcile all religions together, or reconcile all denominations together, reconcile the contradicting issues together, in order actually to have in their mind like a peaceful culture. But the apologetic sermons help to clear this confusion. The second type of sermons, we call it the warning sermons. Warning sermons. Warning sermons are focusing more on the threatening aspect of the character of God. And some churches or some denominations are focusing more on the warning aspect of the character of God. Definitely we need to hear about this, and the Lord Jesus Christ in his preaching, he used many times warning. But to be the only style that are using all the time, this actually may create hopelessness or create despair in the heart of the people, because they will feel whatever they do, there is no hope. Usually it is, there is no motivation, there is no encouragement. That's why, as I said in the beginning, it's important to combine the four styles or to alternate between the four styles during sermons. Warning sermons address the attributes of holiness, justice, sovereignty, and power of God, or they address also human sinfulness, our weakness, our inability, our mortality. And also these sermons address the law of God, the commandment of God, and how God defines sin and wickedness, and how we should stay away from sin, otherwise this will happen to us. Let me give you some examples. Like when the Lord told us, remember Lot's wife. This is actually a warning about drifting from your goal. She was leaving Sodom, but her heart still in Sodom. So when the Lord told us, remember Lot's wife, the message here, if you want to follow Christ, but your heart is still in sin, in the land of Sodom, then actually you will not be saved. So it's a warning. When we speak about Judas, how he was one of the 12, but because he did not repent, and the lack of hope and confidence in the forgiveness of God, he perished. It is also a warning sermon. When we speak about Luke chapter 13, verse 3 and 5, when the Lord said, unless you repent, you all likewise will perish. It is a warning sermon. And again, many verses in the letters of St. Paul, when he spoke about the works of the flesh, and he said, as I told you before, those who are doing these works will not inherit the kingdom of God. So all these types of sermons, we call it warning sermon. So the warning sermon designed to alarm the people who are comfortable in their sins, who are comfortable in their sinful life, to make them anxious, to make them fearful, or even to make them terrified, in order to move them out of their comfort zone and seek repentance and seek actually going back to the Lord. But again, these sermons should not be the only sermons that we hear it all the time. Yes, the Lord used warning messages